Hey, welcome to this FlightGear. Whoa. Yeah, I should tell you some more about ILS landings. I've been receiving questions from you guys multiple times a week about ILS ever since the first episode of FlightGear HowTo was on YouTube. If you look at all the comments, it becomes quite obvious that most of you end up flying in circles and crashing after enabling the autopilot. Let's see why that happens. Here, I just took off from London Gatwick and I'd like to land at Frankfurt Airport, runway 25 left. So I look up the ILS frequency and runway heading and enter them in my radio settings. But now, if I turn on the autopilot, my plane will circle down and eventually crash. That is because ILS is a relatively short-range navigation tool and is only meant for approach. So let's fix this problem by first telling our plane to fly to Frankfurt Airport. Open the route manager, enter the airport's ICAO code and activate it. Then set your autopilot to follow the true heading and wait. Yep. Ah, there we go. I now just have to fly to approximately this point, which is the place where we will be intercepting the ILS signal. As soon as your plane intercepts the ILS signal, you can set the autopilot to perform the correct approach. You can usually see if your plane is picking up any ILS signals by looking right here. This one is for the ILS heading, and this one is for the glide slope path. Thanks for watching this how-to, and don't forget to film your landings and submit them as video responses to this video. I hope to see you back next time for a more in-depth look into the route manager.